Good evening, and thank you for joining us. I'm Alex Flood. The province of Ontario is reporting 9,418 new COVID cases today. It's the fourth straight day of more than 9,000 cases, and the surge is also being seen here in the Northwest. The Thunder Bay District Health Unit recorded 89 new cases over the past 3 days. 76 of them are in the Thunder Bay area, while the other 13 are from the district. The active case count is now sitting at 152, up from 91 on Christmas Eve. There's been no change in the number of COVID patients in the regional hospital at 3, with none in the ICU. Meanwhile, the numbers are still rising in the Northwestern Health Unit area. There are 79 new cases since Friday, and the number of active cases there has risen to 172. 24 of the new cases are in the Kenora area, and another 24 are in Dryden. There are 12 new cases in Sioux Lookout, 8 in Red Lake, 6 in Fort Francis, and 5 in Emo. The owner of the Finnish Labour Temple is once again pledging to rebuild the historic structure after it was destroyed by fire last week. Brad McKinnon spoke with Dougal Media today from his home in Barrie. He plans to be back in Thunder Bay later this week, and he's already been consulting with his architect about how to recreate the beloved century-old building and, of course, its iconic Hoito restaurant.
Going forward, I will use all of the resources available to me, from friends, family, the insurance company, personal finances. I vow this is my pledge to the community to rebuild the Finnish Labour Temple, to restore the Bay Street facade, to restore the tower, to restore the cupola, to bring the Hoito restaurant back. This building became part of my family. And losing this building was like having a limb amputated. It was like losing one of my children. So it's been very, very difficult for me. But at the same time, everyone needs to know that, you know, I'm a strong, stubborn, determined individual. And I feel that I owe this to the community to get this building back.
Meanwhile, local fire investigators were back on scene this morning and will be providing the media with an update on their probe tomorrow. As 2021 comes to a close, we took the opportunity to speak to the mayor and our federal and provincial politicians about the past year, and we asked each of them to choose one political highlight of 2021.
From 2021, the thing I'm the most proud of is that I was able to get resources to our community, that when they were needed, you know, that I was the voice of the community and was able to address them and get them things done.
Well, getting reelected, I think, is the biggest highlight. We had an election, as you know, this summer, and I was the successful candidate, and I'm still the Member of Parliament for Thunder Bay Superior North, and it's a huge honor.
It's probably an obvious one, but a political highlight from 2021, Marcus.
Getting elected, how about that?
For me, the highlight was the tremendous work done by my Liberal caucus colleagues and myself, fighting to try and make sure that the Ford government did the right things, particularly related to the COVID-19 outbreak. We were pushing them to make decisions, and we're going to continue to do that.
Well, I don't know if it's as much of a political highlight, but certainly, you know, I take gratitude in the way the community and all of the players and partners and individuals came together on the COVID front.
It's a winter wonderland outside as Thunder Bay received its first post-Christmas snowstorm. Families and children across the city are making the most of some heavy snowfall by taking the fun to the hills. Jessica Clement has more.
With the snow coming down with no signs of stopping, you'd think you want to curl up at home by the fire. But the kids at Balsam Pit Park have a different idea. Children of all ages have taken their winter gear and sleds out to enjoy the snowy day. The reactions we've received to sledding during this winter weather have been mixed.
When this calms down, I think it'd be going good. But right now, when you go down this hill right now, when you go down, snow hit the side of you and it feels like hail's hitting your face.
I mean, the wind blowing on your face, it's not the nicest thing in the world, but the snow is pretty powdery and good.
The hard part is you had to walk up the slippery hill. It's not fun. And you have to be careful when you go down, because if you head down that way, you're just getting snow to your face.
It was good. We had perfectly good snow fluff. We went fast.
More snow is expected in the Thunder Bay forecast this week, so if you enjoy sledding, be sure to get out there while the snow is still fresh. Jessica Clement, TVT News.
The local council for the Knights of Columbus is providing warm coats for children to help keep them warm during their walks to school this winter. The recent donation of 48 new coats was made to Precious Bundles, which in turn is supporting Eco-Superior's Walk or Wheel Thunder Bay initiative. With temperatures getting colder and the snow not going away anytime soon, organizers with Walk or Wheel and Precious Bundles decided to collaborate to give kids warm clothes for their trips to and from school. And after hearing about that new partnership, the Knights of Columbus wanted to help out as well through their Coats for Kids program.
The cold in the winter time, if you don't have a warm jacket or the proper boots, then that can be a real barrier. And so this partnership with Precious Bundles allows us to provide more winter clothes to elementary students.
When we heard about WOW T-Bay's initiative in promoting active transportation and travel to school for local students and their partnership with Precious Bundles, we thought that was a great fit for us to be able to provide winter coats through our Knights of Columbus Coats for Kids program.
The City of Thunder Bay will once again be recycling natural Christmas trees this holiday season. Residents can drop off their trees at 9 locations around the city, including Brent Park on Balsam Street and the West Fort Playing Fields. The city says trees cannot be left at recycling depots or be put out for curbside collection. Residents using the drop-off site should remove all ornaments and tinsel beforehand. And if a plastic bag was used to transport the tree, it should be removed as well. The drop-off sites will be open 24 hours a day until January 12th. A Thunder Bay resident is once again spreading Christmas cheer through an eye-popping musical light show displayed on his home on North Syndicate Avenue. And it's not just for raising spirits, it's also helping raise money for a cause that's personal to the family.
The lights are timed to over 20,000 notes.
Over the last 9 holiday seasons, Thunder Bay resident James Hill has assembled and displayed a number of spectacular light shows, adding more features each year and leaving community members speechless. This season, he's outdone himself with Listen to the Lights, a programmed display which features 4,500 lights controlled by 2,500 channels, a 16-foot snowflake, and of course, 4 singing light bulbs, all perfectly synced to a variety of Christmas songs on his own radio channel. Running until December 31st, Hill says a tremendous amount of work is involved, but the result is incredibly rewarding.
If I'm going to set up my lights, it probably takes me about 2 days or so to actually put the physical lights out. But I spend most of my time sitting in front of a computer programming the lights to the music. Right now, with all that I've got, I'm looking at, for a 3-minute song, roughly 40 hours of programming.
Hill is also asking for donations to Our Hearts at Home cardiovascular surgery program in Thunder Bay. The program is a personal one for Hill, as his family has been affected by high blood pressure, heart disease, as well as a recent heart attack. Although he doesn't have a specific goal for donations, Hill hopes to raise as much awareness as possible for the program, with a personal need to give back by helping out the hospital with their campaign.
We kindly ask that you make a donation to www.healthsciencesfoundation.ca/lights in support of Our Hearts at Home cardiovascular surgery program.
From my family to all of Thunder Bay, this is our little gift to you. So come out and enjoy. I hope you like the music as much as I enjoy programming.
Running until January 2nd, Thunder Bay residents are invited to stop by the North Syndicate Avenue home and tune in to 92.3 FM from 6 to 10 during the week and 6 to 11 Friday to Sunday. Joined now with Kurt Black. Wow, that was a fun story to do and a great story to go along with it, obviously. Arguably the best light show we have in town. It was a pleasure to cover it.
It's quite the show.
It was.
Now, it wasn't as good of a show, I have to say, as the World Junior Action that got underway just yesterday. And you know what? if you're with the family or you're doing Boxing Day shopping or hibernating after a crazy Christmas day, you're in luck because we have all the highlights, all the action from yesterday right after the break.